Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to ABL Basketball on Hub Sports Arena as we bring you a regular season game between the red-hot Saigon Heat and the second-place playoff-bound Singapore Slingers from right here at the OCBC Arena, the Lion City of Singapore. Both these teams coming off of successful games, but it was the Heat that raised the most eyebrows as they defeated the league champions, Hong Kong. We'll talk about that a little bit later. Confirmation of our games today, Singapore Slingers going against the Saigon Heat. The Slingers with a record of 12-6. Saigon checking in with 7-10, but on the rise. We want to apologize. The arena here, there is a power problem. We'll get that sorted out for you just as soon as we can. But in the meantime, we'll be talking about both these teams and some of the coaches. And we talked to Coach Anthony Garbellato first from the Saigon Heat with his impressions of the team and their red hot start to the season and what they've been doing lately.
I mean, statistically, we're the second best team in this second series of games. We got three really tough games to go, two against obviously the Slingers and one against Hong Kong. And so for us, we want to try to keep our momentum and playing well together this moment and see if we can just make this extra win to get into the playoffs.
Well, I'm pretty happy with their energy and effort, and basically we played throughout the 40 minutes. So hopefully we can keep it up these last two games and moving forward towards our momentum to the playoff.
You know, we want to get the third spot. Fourth is good, but that I feel like that's just kind of scraping by. You know, we want to exceed our expectations. So third is what we're going for.
I think we match up really well. We've got very, very, very good balance. And I'm hopeful that if we can get this one win in these next three games, that we can be a real trouble to whoever we play in the playoffs.
Well, as we mentioned before, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions going down at the hands of the Saigon Heat by a score of 96-92 on Friday night. Feel-good story for the Slingers as well. A 76-52 win for them last Sunday against the Kaohsiung team, the Truth. Singapore before that had lost four of their last six games. If we look at the team standings, confirmation, Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, they are the league champions. Checking in with a 15-3 record. Singapore Slingers at 12-6. They will finish second. A lot of Pilipinas and Saigon Heat up in the air to see which team will finish third and fourth right now. A lot of Pilipinas 9-9, Saigon 7-10. Westport Malaysian Dragons, a young team, a lot better than their record would indicate, 6-13. Kaohsiung Truth at 5-13. So both these teams, Singapore Slingers and the Saigon Heat, have a long history in the ABL. We'll check out their head-to-head matchups. And all together, the Slingers hold a whopping 14-3 lead, not including, well, including that is a loss against the Saigon Heat a couple of weeks ago, as you said, 75-72. Chuck Schreiner along with Michael Wong will be bringing the game commentary to you today from the OCBC Arena. Michael, as we get ready for these teams to start, bad news on the Slingers front. They're going to be without one of their big stars today in this game.
Yes, received news that Mr. X will not be playing today. So he brings a lot to the team. He brings, remember, if you remember correctly, right, a few weeks ago he just recorded a triple-double. So it speaks a lot about what he brings to the team. He brings in scoring, rebounds and assists. Most importantly, right, he's someone who can get himself into the paint and create opportunities for Howard, for open shooters like Luka Boyce. So it's a big loss to the Singapore Slingers.
Well, Xavier Alexander held out because of a sore shoulder. They expect him to be back in next week. And I guess Coach Ngo and company and Coach Johnson are playing the percentages, Michael. No sense taking a chance on another injury right before the playoffs. Of course, the championship, what it's all about. Singapore has already clinched second place. They can't finish any lower, so better to have everybody healthy when it rolls into the playoffs.
It's definitely a very wise move by the management, because right now they're locked in at number two seed, so they don't need anything moving forth. So right now is the best time to rest your big guns, you know, give them some rest, get them in rhythm, you know, rest the nagging injuries that they have and get ready for the playoffs, because playoffs going to be hectic. It's going to be three games in a span of 7 days. It's going to be riding them out all the way. So it's a wise move.
Okay, so Saigon Heat getting ready to be introduced right there. Saigon Heat, we say, coming off a very, very soul-lifting victory over the first-place team Hong Kong the other night on Friday by a score of 96-92. Now the caveat to that, of course, Hong Kong without their big man Josh Boone, who we understand will be out today in their game also against the La Pilipinas. game will have some repercussions on the Saigon Heat team. As you heard in the interview, David Arnold saying the Saigon Heat don't want to just scrape into the playoffs. They want at least third position. And some things have to happen for that to occur. We'll be going over some of those permutations with you later on. But this is the Saigon Heat team being introduced. And the top five players, the starting five, introduced just a moment ago, and here come the Singapore Slingers with a record of 12-6, the second best record in the league. They finished second place last year, remember, losing out in the finals, a hard-fought finals against the Malaysian Dragons. So with that injury to Alexander, Desmond O will get the start. Here are some of the other players. They are sky high for this game. They're going to look at it as a challenge, Michael Wong. Can they do it without the X-Man? For that to happen, a lot of things are going to have to occur. The local guys, as you pointed out before the game when we were having a conversation, are going to have to hit their outside shots. They're going to have to play very, very well for the Slingers to have a chance against this very super stock team from Saigon, who are peaking just at the right time. And there is Alexander, the guy we were talking about. Credit to his leadership and his presence that even though he's not playing today, he is suiting up. He wants to be on the bench with these Slingers.
Yeah, it's a good sign for the local boys because they got to bring in the energy. It also allows some of those who are just coming back from injuries to get rhythm before the playoffs. They want to make sure they get some burn on the court, get some feel of the game speed so that when they come playoffs, they are ready.
Desmond O getting the start along with newcomer Josh Erzbin Tondo, the 6'1 guard, the 34-year-old guy. They picked him up to add a spark to the Slingers offense and some experience also getting the start today. Mitch Volkoff coming off an injury, the 27-year-old Delvin Goh will get a start today. He's been doing very well. Great footwork being exhibited. He can go the left hand now. He provides that extra dimension that the Slingers need. Another big man in the lineup, and there's the heart and soul of the team, Justin Howard. Second in the league of rebounds, a 6'11", 35-year-old, averaging 21.5 points a game and over 17 rebounds. They will need all of that and more if the Slingers are going to hold fast today and get out of here with a win. Remember, they go on the road next week for their last game against the Saigon Heat, but it will be at their place. So the Slingers would like to obviously sweep these last two games and get some momentum, but more than that, they want to be healthy going into the playoffs, so I think they're very wise in resting the X-Man, and we'll see what happens with this. This is a team, they know each other very well. They've played two games against each other, splitting the two games. Remember, at their place, Singapore won earlier on the season, and then the Saigon Heat came back a couple weeks ago, and some of the game clips you saw at the beginning of the show, they come away with a 75-72 win. And there are some of the crowd, good-looking crowd here at the OCBC Arena. As we look at the starting five for both these teams, we'll put the graphic up for you so you can see Saigon Heat, Nguyen, Lenny Daniel, averaging 22 points. Again, Moses Morgan, who Coach Garletto says he's their most impressive pickup in the season. Jordan Enriquez, what a presence he is around the basket. And Arnold Viet on the other side, as we said, Erzbin Tondo. It is Leon Kwek, not actually Desmond O, who gets the start. Mitch Volkoff, Delvin Goh, and Justin Howard. So they're going as big as they can. Put a lot of experience in that Slingers lineup, and we'll see what happens against this newly formed Saigon Heat team, who are seeming to gel just at the right time. If you look at the team standings again, Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, 15-3, far and away the best team in the league this year, followed by the Slingers, who have been injury ravaged to say the least, at 12-6. La Pilipinas at 9-9. Their stock has gone down the last few weeks. Saigon Heat on the way up. Westport Malaysian Dragons, 6-13. They are a young team in Kaohsiung Truth. They have been eliminated. They are 5-13, but again, only the first year for their franchise. So if you look at Coach Garlotto and company, there is David Arnold, who we interviewed today, very articulate young man, and he was saying, Michael, that they will not be happy just to make the playoffs. They want to make an impact in the playoffs, and what better way to do it than to come here to Singapore and beat Singapore for the second consecutive time in 2 weeks. What a feather that would be in their cap if they could pull that off.
It's for the Heat to come back roaring into the league, because from the way they started and look at where they are right now, they are in a very good role and a very good position. So for them, this is a must-win game for them to get into the playoffs and to go into the playoffs with the right mentality, the right momentum. So this is a very important game for them.
Very important for the Slingers not to fall behind quickly and early. The Saigon team is a very dynamic team. They have a lot of guys that can do it too. We mentioned Lenny Daniel, but don't forget Moses Morgan. He's 6'6", but he can play the small forward or the guard position. Of course, Jordan Enriquez, he matches up very, very well against Justin Howard on that low post. He's 7 feet tall, only 27 years of age, so getting some experience along the way. He's averaging over 17 points and 14.7 rebounds a game. And David Arnold, the Heritage player, 6'2 guard, averaging 13.3. So they've got four guys that can come at you with double figures and a fairly deep local bunch of guys who probably starting the game today will be Nguyen Van Hung, but they also have Nguyen Tan, or Stefan Nguyen as he likes to be called, 6'3 guard, only 25 years of age, averages 3.5 points a game, but he is up amongst the top 10 in assists too. So a very well coached team. Garbalero has done a fine job with them. They're coming on, they're peaking just at the right time.
Yeah, this is a very strong starting five unit, and all five of them are very good at the positions, and they can score from all positions. So this is a team that's very dangerous moving into the playoffs. Everyone will be very wary of them.
So Singapore coming on the court now in white. Again, shorthand, if you just joined us, there will be no Xavier Alexander today. Shame for the Slingers. Last game, he scored a triple-double, and I believe was the ABL Player of the Week last week against the Kaohsiung Truth. So his third triple-double, but he'll have to be an observer today, and we'll see what the Singapore Slingers can do. An undersized team, and will be a little bit lacking in quickness as well. They're going to have to get it done from the outside. It'll be interesting to see how the Saigon Heat line up against them. Will they go with the zone? Will they go man-to-man? We'll see. A couple weeks ago, as we saw, they came out here and they played a zone, daring Singapore to hit their shots from outside. Singapore was unable to do it, and that was the reason why the Heat came away with that 75-72 win. So Enriquez getting ready to jump it up against Howard, and here we go, right into the hands of number 22. Number two, check that. That was Daniel. Little bounce pass inside to Moses. Moses shucking and jiving inside. Backs up shot off the rim and out. Howard with the rebound, and away with it comes Erzben Tonto. Erzben Tonto on that right hand side. Nguyen working on him. Kwek, who gets the start, swings it over to the right. Screen, and off of that goes Howard. Howard, long two is no good. Moses gets the rebound. Back he comes. Oh, good ball movement. Daniels, and can't get it, but a foul underneath. And Lenny Daniel will go to the line for two. And we watch it again, doing a good job. Look at the no-look pass there by Enriquez. And yes, catching, I think, will be Justin Howard. So Howard with one foul. That will put Enriquez at the line. Check that, Daniels at the line. Daniels averaging 22 points a game. Sends home the first one. Saigon, a very good free throw shooting team. Singapore, on the other hand, not so much, around 58%. Daniels, one of two. Erzben Tonto and company will bring it down. Erzben Tonto came on a little bit last week and shooting, had 8 points. Howard way outside. He'll give it up and throw the screen. He'll roll off that. Getting inside, yes! Good move by Quet. Fending off his defender with the left shoulder, up with the left hand, 2-1 Singapore. Arnold, Quek on him. Quickly inside, Durant pass, the first turnover of the game. Trying to force the ball inside to Enriquez, and a little bit of a wild pass. So Singapore will try and take advantage of that. Where's Bentondo? Volkoff, Howard. It's free for a moment. Oh, putting the ball on the floor is go. And what is that? 3 second violation. Well, go should have gone straight up, and he did not. He put the ball on the floor, and that's what Howard's telling him right there. I got you the ball right where you needed it. No need to hesitate. Arnold off to Daniel. Daniel waiting for movement. Coming up, throwing the screen, a little back screen. The ball is on the floor. Little hesitation move inside. It's off the mark. Enriquez trying to send it back up. No good. Erzben Tonto in the open court. He'll take it with the left hand. Look left. Gets it over to Quek. Inside to Howard. Howard double pump fake. Up and can't get it to go. Enriquez now has it back to Daniel. Daniel with the headband there on the left hand side. Check that. That is Moses. Moses Morgan. Arnold now uses one screen, goes to the left hand, kicks it back outside. Enriquez calling for the ball. Remember, Howard with one foul. A little backup jumper going to be way off the mark. Erzben Tonto with the rebound back on the Slingers. Left hand, Volkoff using the body up and in. Somebody missed a defensive assignment. Heads up move by the Slingers, looking good in the early going, Michael.
Yeah, the energy level is definitely better than the last time we played them at home.
So 4-1 is your score. Enriquez bouncing off of go. Check, that was Daniels getting the separation, the backup jumper there. So 4-3 very quickly. Daniels sometimes is a slow starter. He's been known to turn it on in the second half. Howard, nice move there. ball is blocked by Enriquez. Howard gets it back. A little shot launch from the right-hand side. 15-footer, good. Singapore up 6-3. Back comes Arnold and company. Left-hand build up that time, giving the ball off to Enriquez. Up pops Nguyen on that right-hand side. He's yet to get a touch. Long shot again, and off the mark. So Erzben Tondo will force it back down the court, and reverse knocked away. Good recovery that time by Lenny Daniel. Check, that was Moses Morgan to knock it away. Quick. A little bit too nonchalant with this. You can see a little bit slow on the reverse. Good recognition there by Erzben Tondo, but Moses Morgan doing a great job on the weak side to come over and block it away. Singapore with the ball, Erzben Tondo. Little backup jumper there is off the mark. Tipped over to Howard, who'll take that shot. Nobody coming out on him. That's a shot, Michael, he can hit all day long. 8-3, Singapore with a 5-point lead.
So Howard looks good on those two jumpers. It seems like he's getting his lift back.
Nguyen, Enriquez. Shot changed by Howard, back into the hands of Howard. Erzben Tondo pushing the ball. Volkoff with the right hand. Very quickly, Singapore with a 10-3 lead, and Saigon's going to have to call a timeout. Great open court play by the Slingers early on, Michael Wong.
The Slingers look to push at every single opportunity they get.
There it is again, Volkoff using the glass. Watch how he uses that left shoulder to fend away the defender. Singapore surprisingly up 10-3, even without Alexander. Look at that. Garbalato going ballistic on the sidelines, does not like the energy level that he has seen, and I sort of agree with him. They've just come out very, very flat. You know, sometimes, and Garbalato mentioned this before the game, Michael Wong, he said last game on Friday, even though they won the game, they found that Hong Kong was a much tougher team to play without Josh Boone, because if you have him in the game, it's a given. He's going to get the ball down low. I think they're sort of running into the same trap for the Slingers, but no Alexander there. This means that the burden has to go on a lot of other guys, and it looks like Saigon's, all their game plan was geared to stopping Alexander and Howard. Well, with other guys getting some touches now and forcing the ball in the open court, very quickly getting the ball out on those outlet passes, they're giving Saigon a lot to think about early on the going, and Garbalero just wants to send home that message early on so that Saigon can recover and get back in this game. But nice hustle plays by the Singapore Slingers in general, especially Mitch Volkoff and Josh Erzben Tondo. Nguyen punches the ball back outside to Arnold. Man-to-man defense, long three by Arnold. Nobody on the shooter. So 10-6, his first bucket of the game. Erzben Tondo swings it over to the right. Erzben Tondo slides through. Quek around the free throw line. He steps up. Howard now. Quek, left hand. Good defense. It'll fall away. Jumper. It's going to be good. Well, with only a couple ticks left on the clock, a two there. So Leon Quek with two buckets. Off balance shot, a push from behind. Who is that going to go on? Push on Enrique, so an offensive foul. First foul on Saigon, and Garbalero continues to be livid over on the sidelines. 12-6, Singapore with a 6-point lead, matching their biggest lead of the game. Really impressed with that last shot by Leon Quek, leaning backwards, the one-legged jumper. Mitch Volkoff, Erzben Tondo for a three. Yes! Got Erzben Tondo. 15-6 Singapore. Check out 14. So 8-point lead. Arnold slicing through the lane and a foul, and that will go on Delvin Goh. His first foul, not moving his feet, so sort of sticking the hand in the lane. That's a no-no. Watch Delvin. So instead of sliding his feet, you can see he was his attention was centered on number 24, Enriquez. So trying to get the job done, but the hands all over David Arnold as he came sliding through. Arnold at the line for two. He's already got 3 points. It's the first of two, 14-7 now. Singapore, the best defensive team in the league, giving up just over 75 points a game. Check that, 73 points a game. Remember, they only gave up 52 last week against Tiao Xiong. So Arnold getting two back. Singapore up by six. Erzben Tondo yo-yoing down the right-hand side. back outside to go. Gives it off to Falkoff, who throws the screen, around the screen. Pull-up jumper. This is badly, but right back to the hands of Howard. Howard, Volkov. Volkov right-hand, he traveled. So second turnover for Singapore. That's too bad, especially when Singapore got a second kick at the can, but you can see quite clearly Mitchell Volkov shuffling his feet, Michael.
I mean, going back to the point that you said about the Hong Kong Lions, right? I think that Singapore Swingers, the local boys, are really feeling very loose right now because I'm not saying that X-Men is there and they can't play, but without the X-Men, they know they have to come up with something extra. They need to give an extra point here, you know, get an extra rebound here as well.
Shot is short by Daniel. Away with it comes Quek. Quek quickly moving the ball down the court. Singapore looking much the quicker team early on. Earthman Tondo turns his defender around in the lane. High off the glass and in. Oh, what a play by Josh Earthman Tondo. Wow. Shades of his PBA self that time, shaking loose the defender high off the glass and scoring it. Matching the biggest lead of the game, Singapore. Little full court pressure there. Just with the Dr. O to go. Right around him goes Daniel and up and in. Weak side helps slow to develop right there. Delvin Goh, not the quickest guy on the court. Erzben Tondo to Howard. Enrique is working on him. Howard missing the shot. Enrique is there to clean it up. Back comes Saigon. 3:43 to go here in the first quarter. And right to the basket, but that is becoming something of a regular play now. That was Nguyen that time. Stefan Nguyen. His first bucket of the game, and all of a sudden a four-point game. Ball swung around to Quek. Quek looking inside. Out pops Erzben Tondo. Downstairs to Howard. Enriquez working on him. Howard bumping and grinding. Turns. One-handed shot. Yeah. Getting the separation. So Justin Howard picking up the slack. He's now got six. Six-point lead by the Slingers. Inside the lane and back out it goes Arnold. Volkov working on him. Turns his defender around, up and in. Nice play by Howard. Mitchell turned the wrong way that time. So 18-14, Saigon starting to make some noise. Erzben Tondo, bounce pass inside to go or to Quek. Outside again to Howard. Popping back around is Erzben Tondo from Threesville. Yeah! John Erzben Tondo trying to pick up the slack for the X-Man and doing a great job. His second triple of the game, Michael.
I guess that's why he's in the starting lineup. He's been playing very well, pushing the tempo at every single chance they get and hitting open shots like this.
There he is, helping out on D. Shot from that left-hand side, yes, I think that's a three if it is. And that was Nguyen that time. Hung Nguyen Van. So 4-point lead at the 2-minute mark for the Slingers. Chuck Schreiner along with Michael Wong. So happy you could join us on this sultry Sunday afternoon here in Singapore. Next to the last regular season game, go thinking about it. Takes the shot. Rims off. One and out for the Slingers. That is Lenny Daniel off the dribble. Still Daniel. That'll be a two if it goes. It does not. Punched up in the air right to the path of Howard. Howard will give it up. Erzben Tondo. Fires up another three. That's going to be off the mark. Ill-advised shot there by Josh. Now rushing it down the court is Daniel. Oh, yes, and one. Well, getting in his path, I believe, was Quek, and he will get the foul. So opportunity now for Saigon to get to within one as we look at it again, forcing the pace once again, a little show and go. Leon Quek moving his feet, just cannot get out of the way. See Delvin go standing statue-like again. So opportunity now for Saigon to get within one. So Coach Garbaletto breathing a little bit easier as this team trail by as many as eight. Chance now to get to within one and almost an offensive board, but Go stepping in. Here comes Quek again, pushing the ball hard for the Slingers. Erzben Tondo flashing through. Stepping up is number 11, who's just checked into the game, Larry Liu, and the ball knocked away. So untimely turnover there for the Slingers. Here comes Nguyen. He view on him. Goes around the screen, getting a step. Inside he goes, can't get it. Coming away with it is Howard. Or has been Tonto, the lead pass. Shot by Liu is in and out. Followed up, in and out again. Easy two for Enriquez, and he slams it home, and that will tie to 21 with under 35 seconds to go here in the first quarter. So the long trip back by Saigon, starting to find their rhythm now. Inside, the ball thrown away. So last four possessions, Michael, Singapore has thrown it away three times.
Yeah, those are very bad turnovers that resulted in some transition points, some easy points for the Saigon Heat. They got to take care of the basketball a little bit better.
So, by my count, that's four turnovers for Singapore in the first quarter. Saigon has three. Inbounding it is Nguyen. Off to his running buddy, Stephon Nguyen. Under 30 seconds to go. 17 on the shot clock, so about a 4 second differential between game clock and shot clock. Enrique with the screen. Around him is Liu. Inside, oh, getting behind the defense. Good play. Just lurking. So 10 seconds, Saigon with a 23-21 lead, their first lead of the game. There's been Tondo, kicks it back outside. Around the horn it goes. Shot from the left-hand side is no good. And that will do it at the buzzer. So the Saigon Heat do enough to take the lead. They lead 23-21 at the OCBC Arena at the end of one stanza. We'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. After one quarter that's in the books, 23-21 Saigon Heat, after a few hiccups at the first, have regained their footing to take that slim lead over the Singapore Slingers. Leading the way there, number two, Lenny Daniels. You look at the stats, 10 of 22 from the floor from the Slingers, 9 and 19 for Saigon. Turnovers 3 and 1, assists 4 and 5, rebounds 14 and 8. Singapore with a big bulge there, but 3-point shooting, 2 of 2. So, as one might expect by looking at the stats, a nearly even Steven game here going into the second quarter. Singapore in white will inbound it. Larry Liu stays in the game, Wong Wei Long checking into the game now for the Singapore Slingers. Howard, Enrique's on him, the kick back outside. Wong, with Bentano gets a blow. Wong checks in for him. Going to the left hand, gets trapped. Outside shot, a long three is going to be off the mark. Howard fighting for it inside. Ball's on the court, picked up by Nguyen. Ball knocked away. Good job by Wong. And a foul. Tumbling down goes Justin Howard. He should be okay. The big man gets up. Got his legs caught up with number 10. Watch it again. That was Nguyen. Tuan Vinh. There he is, a push from behind. Good hustle by Wong to get the possession back after the one and out. Looking at the stats in that first quarter, 10 to 22 for Singapore. 1 of 2 from beyond the arc. Howard, Wong, Desmond Owen the game now too. So Singapore trying to keep their legs fresh. Inside Howard, little hesitation move, the backup hook is good. Nice footwork by Justin Howard on the low blocks. Gets a separation from Enriquez like he's done a couple of other times, and Justin now with eight. Moses Morgan working on Liu. Little bounce pass inside, kicked away that time by Howard, so it will be Saigon ball. We have a 23-23 game here at the 9-minute mark here in the second quarter. Remember, Singapore 12-6. They have already clinched second place. Saigon Heat fighting for their playoff lives at 7-10. Should they win today, they will clinch that fourth and final playoff spot and the opportunity, in fact, to get a third spot. But that's for later games to decide. David Arnold around one screen by Desmond. Oh, Desmond. Pops it inside, little show and go there. Real quick shot by Enriquez, rattles that one home. So Saigon again with the 2-point lead. Back comes Wong and company. Looking inside, downstairs to Howard. Almost had Quet. Meaning shot there is gonna be off the mark. Tipped up in the air, right into the path of Enriquez. Enriquez quickly gives it up to Moses Morgan, who hoists a long freeze off the mark, right into the path of Larry Liu. Bark signals here, he will run the point. Swings the ball over to the right. Hong Kong, and a man-to-man at the moment, and a push, and that will go on number 10, Nguyen Thanh Vinh, I believe. Watch it again. It's gonna go actually on David Arnold, number 33. So one foul on him is Coach Garbaletto. Very animated coach, very articulate coach too. We'll see a little bit more of him at halftime, but maybe not believing the call on the floor. Pretty obvious to us. Wow, that'll be a technical foul. Huh. So Lenny Daniel and Arnold trying to get clarification. Howard will be at the line. He'll shoot two, misses the first one. So Singapore will have two kicks at the can from the free throw line and the ball out of bounds at the 8:09 mark. We said before, Singapore and only one of the ball, excuse me. Desmond O, Singapore and Saigon splitting their two games. Wong, still Wong in the lane. Wide open look for Quick on the left side. Buries it, long two. That'll tie it up at 25. Quick has had a good season, the 20-year-old, one of the futures of, and see a push there. Well, who will that be on? I believe it'll be on Quick. Yes, it will be a holding on foul. Thought for a minute they may call that on Lenny Daniel. You can see Leon Quick just popping out of the picture there, so it looked for all the world like he'd been pushed, but there was a hole before that. Arnold will inbound it on the baseline, back outside to Daniel. Daniel to Nguyen. Wong working on him, a little turnaround jumper again, that time off the mark by Enrique. Wong, still Wong. Finds Quick, Desmond O, over to Howard. Enrique working on him, looking for movement. Liu with the shot off the mark. Howard stepping in the lane and picking it off. Second chance opportunity for Singapore. Good rebound there by Howard. Hustle play by him. Inside on the reverse. Followed by Howard. Great timing by Justin Howard. 10 for him. Singapore up by a pair. Really taking up the slack, Michael Wong, and a foul away from the ball. Boy, oh boy, Leon Quick getting himself very quickly in foul trouble. I believe that will be three on Leon. Yeah, it is. There's Desmond O, and the follow there, and really you can make the case for a foul. Looked like Enrique wrapped his arm around Desmond O's face. Enrique. Still Enrique, the ball gets his own rebound on the reverse, misses it again. Wong has the ball, he'll hold it up. Checking into the game now is For Quick, he throws the screen and rolls off of that. Wong, no, it's Desmond O. Had a shot for a moment. Go in the game now too. Singapore, six on the shot clock. Shot's gonna be way off the mark that time, so Singapore wasted possession that time. And here comes David Arnold and company. A chance to tie it up here. 6:22 to go here in the second quarter. Off the dribble, Moses Morgan. Well, Coach Garbaletto said that with the presence of Moses Morgan in the lineup, Saigon became a different team, went to a different level. Back outside to Howard. Howard gets his shot partially blocked. And a travel call. I believe he just dropped the ball and picked it up again. That's illegal. So a turnover for Singapore. Saigon will get the ball. Watch it again. Yeah, you can't do that. Nice try, Justin. So Arnold and company. Good-looking crowd here on a Sunday afternoon. For the Slingers, the playoff-bound Singapore Slingers. Morgan, still Morgan, looking for separation around the screen. That'll be a two if it goes. It'll be off the mark. Howard steps in the lane. Back on the Slingers once again. 5:34 to go here in the second quarter. Nguyen working on Wong. Go. Ung now, back downstairs again. Go trying to work that left foot, and what do we have here? A charging foul on Go. Wow.
I think Go extended his arm and he had a little hook.
But he,
you see it here?
They're trying that little drop step move there. It didn't fool anybody, least of all Moses Morgan. So you're right, Michael, charging with that elbow inside. So another turnover. Arnold now, there's the screen. Arnold accelerates, gets the ball off to Enrique for the slam. You can see that developing. All started with the screen. On the other side now. Go pops up, gives the ball to Desmond O. Lots of movement by the Slingers, but good defensive pressure, and it's knocked off one more time. So every time the ball's on the floor, taking advantage of the lead pass up and in. Wow. So three trips down the floor, three turnovers for the Slingers, and the Slingers are going to have to call a timeout. We said, we predicated, you know, the Slingers might have a chance in this game, but they've got to take care of the ball. So far in the second quarter, they have not, Michael Wong.
Yeah, you really want to work the Saigon hit on their defense and not give up easy transition points for them like this by just turning the ball over.
Watch this off the dribble and getting caught in no man's land. Desmond O not able to get around the screen. That was a play before that. Enrique then at the other end, the steal and the putback at the other end. So 31-27, Saigon in control here in the second quarter. And, you know, if you're Coach Nyo, you keep working at your combinations, keep your legs fresh in there. Urzben Tondo, of course, he's 34 years of age, so you can't really push the envelope too much with him, but he's your best offensive threat. But you kind of want your defenders, your Desmond O's and people like that, to make these defensive stands so that you can get the ball back quickly and maybe cause some turnovers. But it's worked opposite for them. It's been Singapore who's been turning over the ball, and Saigon taking advantage here all throughout the second quarter. Just joined us, remember, Xavier Alexander unavailable today. So Singapore is going to have to do it with arguably their best player in the last month of play. He's had three triple-doubles in the last four games. There he is there, the X-Man. So sort of a tribute to his team demeanor that he would dress up today and sit on the bench, but he's there just in case, but I don't think the Slingers want to use him. So 4:40 to go here. There's been Tondo back into the game, as is Wong and Hung Bin Han. Back outside it goes. Wong to Howard. Howard will take that shot and miss it. Right into the lane of Quek. High off the glass. Good. Nice job by Quek. He was playing with three fouls, and that'll bring Singapore back to within two with the 4:12 to go here in the second quarter. Daniels. Bounce pass to Enriquez. Howard giving him a wide berth. Getting around two defenders. Ball knocked away. Good job, Singapore in the open court. Urzben Tondo now. Lead pass to Wong. Wong, still Wong. Yes, it won. Great job by Wong Wei Long getting around his defender. His defender fouling from behind. Wong with the continuation. Watch it again. There he is getting around Nguyen, and Nguyen getting him. Well, it wasn't much of a foul, but enough to draw the whistle from the referee. So opportunity now for Singapore to go up by one with perhaps their best free throw shooter at the line of Wong Wei Long. He does just that. So Singapore with their nose ahead here at the 350 mark. Nguyen to Daniel. Sons, the headband that he had at the beginning of the game. Arnold gets a step on Wong, nowhere to go. Good ball movement, ball in the corner, left-hand shot or left-hand corner is no good. Ball on the floor, diving for it, coming up with it is David Arnold, but intercepted by Erzben Tondo, and he slips on something, the ball out of bounds, and I think Saigon will get it back. Erzben Tondo claiming somebody tripped me. Saying, you think I tripped over my own feet? If you could read his mind. Right there and there. There's where he says the contact was. Let's see another angle. There. Yeah, I think Erzben Tondo has a point. So the Slingers will get the ball back. No, they will not. Enriquez. Looking for the screen. Now gets the ball up in the air to Arnold. Arnold, three defenders on him, but the trailer. Enriquez finishing it off. So nobody getting in the lane. Enriquez taking advantage of his height. Scores in the lane. Wong. Back outside. Quex, of course, spreading out the offense. Howard now has his shot change and a traveling call. Good defensive move there by number 24, Jordan Enriquez, a 27 years old. He has looked better every game, Michael.
Yeah, remember the last game that he had with us? He had 5 blocks, so he's definitely a presence in the paint.
Arnold, Wong on him, inside again to Enriquez. Throws the screen, Howard, baseline. Moses Morgan will be off of that shot. Tips it over to Erzben Tondo, who will push it. Left-hand dribble. Now he'll wait for help. Inside the lane. Wong off the glass, up and in. Nobody picked him up. Singapore with a one-point lead. 2:22 mark. Wong Wei Long. It's a veteran move right there, sensing that there was no defender going with him. Rushes the ball to the rack. Screen. Arnold, two, no good. Howard, rebound. Gets the ball off to Erzben Tondo, who pushes it once again. Still Erzben Tondo in the lane. Kick back outside. Go. Screen. Thought about it, was Wong. Up to the side. Quex step up jumper. Yes! Little head fake sends his defender past him, Michael. Leon Quex showing some poise.
Yeah, he's picking up the scoring slack left by the X-Men. He's showing very good range right now and very confident in his shot.
Check it out again. Gets Morgan to jump at him. Calmly steps up and nails the jumper. Singapore with a three-point lead. Timeout by Saigon by Anthony Garbellato. And, you know, just when it looks like Saigon has figured it out, they come back. They take a 2-3-4-point lead. Singapore right back at him. Lack of perhaps concentration on the part of Saigon, but you can't take anything away from the Slingers. They know their big offensive force is not going to be playing tonight, so they're stepping it out, sharing the wealth, so to speak. Leon Quek right now in double figures. Justin Howard being the guy that distributes the ball now. Singapore pushing all the buttons early on here in the fourth quarter, Michael.
It's evident that the Singapore Slingers are trying to run the offense through Howard. And with that, he brings in the double team and he brings a lot of open shots for the local boys, and it's great to see them hit some outside shots as well, because it gives them the confidence, and the defense will start to spread because of this and giving Howard more room to operate in the down, the low block.
Quick with 10, Howard with 10, Volkoff with 4. The newcomer to the Slingers, Josh Erzben Tondo, checking in with 7 points, and I like what he's doing. He's really providing a lot of energy on offense whenever he gets the chance. He's bringing the ball hard down the court, trying to get back before Saigon can set up their defense, and it's paying dividends for the Slingers right now.
Yeah, he's playing a very heady position right now. He's acting like the little coach on the court, you know, directing the traffic, pushing the tempo. He's doing a very good job.
Saigon in red will inbound the ball from the baseline. David Arnold. Full court pressure by the Slingers. Erzben Tondo. Ooh, almost fouling from behind. Still Erzben Tondo on Nguyen. Nguyen switches to the right hand now. Arnold working on the baseline. Mismatch there we have. Daniel turns and fires. can't get it to roll. Howard pulls down the board. 1:27 to go. Irvin Tondo will slow it down. Singapore doing a better job as of late, taking care of the ball as well. Swings the ball over to Josh again, around one screen with the right hand. Still looking for Howard, kicks it back outside again. Five on the shot clock, around one screen. Quet gets the ball to Howard, knocked away, picked off. Back comes Moses Morgan, and a foul. And that will go on Delvin Goh, number 23, with a blocking foul. So heads up defense by Saigon, and in the open court, that might not have been a bad foul.
Yeah.
Like they had a 4-on-3 developing, Michael.
Yeah, definitely. Looking at the foul situation, they have one more foul to give. I think that was a pretty good foul on Delvin's part.
So Singapore up by three. Red hot Saigon Heat team comes fresh off their victory over Hong Kong the other night. 96-92. Morgan. Shot changed. There's that shot's been open all night long. Back outside to Arnold. Three on the shot clock. He goes up a long three. No good. Howard controls the board. Outlet pass. Wong. Still Wong on the dribble. Irvin Tondo will back it out a little bit. 28 seconds to go. Go. Looking downstairs for Howard. Wide open look. He'll take that shot and bring it home. Delvin Goh. That's an aspect of this game we haven't seen lately. Singapore with a five-point lead inside, and I believe that will be a foul on Delvin. And you can see Lenny Daniel confusing Delvin with that crossover dribble. So three on Delvin. Quek also has three, so those are the two slingers in foul trouble. The other side of the ball, nobody of note. Everybody pretty much has one foul on Saigon's side. So Daniels at the line. That'll stop the clock at 13.5. Singers will likely get one more possession. Daniels, one of the premier offensive players in the league. Also one of the best rebounders in the league, averaging 12.7. He's in the top six there and the top four in scoring. Good pickup in the offseason for the Heat. And one of two. Outlet pass. 10 seconds to go here. Slingers. We'll make sure it's the last possession. There's been Tano to Quek. Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Saigon. Singapore will inbound it with 3.8. Ticks on the clock. We'll be having highlights at the halftime show, along with a little QA, a timeout on the floor by Saigon as they'll try and, or the Slingers, as they'll try and mark it up. More than likely try to get the ball to Howard on that low post. You can bet he'll be surrounded. There's Xavier Alexander, Michael Johnson, and company. The Slingers trying to deny the Saigon Heat a trip to the playoffs. Saigon will have one more kick to the can against the Slingers, but it will be at their place. That will be next Sunday, and that will wrap up the regular season for the Slingers, who will be at home to start off the first game of the playoffs. It looks like it may be a La Pilipinas, but it could be the same Saigon Heat team, depending on what happens today and the rest of the games. Remember, Saigon has to play the Slingers one more time, and they do have to play, I believe they got to play Hong Kong as well. Now, on the other side of the ball, the La Pilipinas has to play Hong Kong one more time, and they also have to play the Kaohsiung Truth. So if you looked at strength of schedule, you'd have to say that La Pilipina has the edge, but the way Saigon has been playing lately, you don't want to give any quarter here this late in the season. And we saw in the interview before the game started, Dave Arnold saying, no, this, you know, we don't want to back into the playoffs with a fourth seed. We would love to have third seed. They feel that they do match up better against the Slingers than they do Hong Kong. But remember, Michael, when the playoffs start, Singapore will be at full strength. So be careful what you wish for if you're Saigon.
Definitely. You know, Singapore Slingers are really rounding up in the shape as well. And with our last two games, being able to adjust and get our bodies some rest, I think the Singapore Slingers will be good for the playoffs.
38-34 is your score. Singapore trying to add to that. Promises to be a scintillating second half. OCBC Arena. Howard now with 2 seconds. Got to get that shot off. Irvin Tano is short with the effort. Design play there. They swing the ball up to Josh. He can't get the basket. It was there. They just couldn't get it to go. So good play. Just execution just a little bit lacking. The crowd nevertheless has to be pleased with the 38-34 score here at the end of the first half. Without the X-Man, Singapore lead. Coach Garbellato joined with referees. We will be back for halftime stuff in just a moment. 38-34, your halftime score here at the OCBC Arena. Welcome back to the OCBC Arena, ladies and gentlemen. 38-34 in favor of the Singapore Slingers. A surprising score, really, over the Saigon Heat. Remember, the Slingers do not have Alexander in the game, but that hasn't seemed to matter that much. And Michael Wong, Chuck Schrein and Michael Wong here, your commentators. And Michael, Singapore acquitting themselves fairly good in the first half. Very close first half, lots of action.
I think they've done a very, very good job without the X-Men. You know, players like Quack, who actually scored 10 points out of 5 of 7 shooting. No, Delvin Goh, he held his fort against Lenny Davids, a known scorer, and he held his ground the whole entire first half, you know, doing well on the defensive end, stopping him on the low block, as well as getting some blocks here and there. I think the local boys have done a very, very good job in the absence of X-Men.
Absolutely. As we look at the first half highlights, there is a wide open there, Volkov. He only had 2 points, using his shoulder very well, driving to the basket for 2 of his 2 points. Back the other way, the Slingers really forcing the action. Actually, 4 points. That's from the other side of the basket for Victor Volkov. Josh Erzbentando, Michael, having a superb first half. High off the glass that time. Really getting some Luzhinovs from the fans. A newest member of the Slingers.
And there's someone I forgot to mention as well. He's been doing a very, very steady job at the point guard position, acting as a second coach on the court as well.
Not all one-way traffic. You see you in there driving to the basket, then the reverse and the follow-up by Howard. Great timing by Justin, who had 12 points in the first half, to give up to Enrique. The power move to the basket. Enrique with 8 points. There has been Tondo again while distributing the ball. Nice job by Wong, seeing that the path was clear of the basket. Veteran move by him inside. Off the dribble. Howard changing the shot, but look at that from behind. Clearing out some spaces, Enrique. There is Wong again. Another veteran KG move. Again, not sensing any defenders by him and taking advantage of it from the left side. Quick little step-up jumper there around Moses Morgan. So Quick with 10 points, as we said, in the first half. If we look at the first half stats, Slinger is 18 to 37, 49%, 14 to 35, cooling off a little bit, Saigon Yi. Free throw rebounds way in the advantage of the Slingers. That might be a surprise without Alexander there, but Singapore controlling the boards, Michael. 26 to 14 turnovers. Well, that's something that the Singapore need to do a little bit better job of. They turn the ball over 8 times. Saigon only 3, so rebounding is the big story there, and shooting percentage all going the way of the Singapore Slingers. So before the game, we talked to Michael Johnson on the state of Singapore basketball here and also on the playoff picture as it develops here for the Singapore Slingers 2016-2017 season.
It's been a tough season. It's you know, we never use excuses, but we've had more injuries than I've ever seen with a team. And coupled with national service and police duties, we've been at some stages only had 7 fit players or available players. So, you know, I think all being said, we've had a pretty good year. And we've given a lot more opportunity than we even have in the past to the local players to stand up and opportunities to play, which I'm really happy about.
And do you feel that it's a case of lost opportunities as far as the league title goes? Not to be repetitive, but at the beginning of the season, everybody thought the Slingers had to be the favorites given their talent at the local level. But lost opportunities besides the injuries, is there anything that you'd like to highlight?
No, look, I mean, the league's got a lot of parity these days. Hong Kong, very strong, a big budget team, so they brought in even recently an NBA players. But, you know, everyone talked about us because we made the finals last year. But, you know, we lost 4 players from last year to national service. And as I said, the injuries have just continued. Seems like after the first few games, we've had someone key player injured. And even tonight, Xavier Alexander won't play because of a shoulder injury. So it's been like that all year. I don't think, I think at parts we've played pretty well, and I think 12-6 is a good reflection of where we're at this point.
You were saying a long time ago that you thought that parity would be one of the highlights of the league this year, and indeed that's proven to be the case. How did you sort of predict that at the beginning of the season, given that there were some new teams? Everybody thought, well, they're going to have you know, the typical beginner's non-luck, if you will, and they won't be able to shine at all. But in the case of Hong Kong, that's been the opposite.
Yeah, I think the teams we brought in, we vetted pretty well, and Hong Kong in particular, a very good organization, very professional, and a big budget team. So we knew they'd be competitive. Kaohsiung took a little while to find their feet, but again, they've got a great passion. There's a lot of talent in Taiwan, so I think they lost last night, which has ruled them out. But Saigon and Malaysia are still fighting for that 4th playoff spot. So I think, you know, going down to the last weekend of the league to have positions still uncertain shows the parity and that we've done a good job, or the league's done a good job in making sure the teams are very competitive.
Of course, the name of the game is to win the championship. Singapore very much in the hunt for that right now. What will the Slingers have to do to bring that dream that we've had for the last couple of years to reality?
Look, we've guaranteed a home court advantage in the semifinal by finishing second, no matter what the results of the last 2 games. And that's a big thing for us. And I think with everyone, once Xavier is back, he should be back next week and ready to go. And we've got more of the players that have been injured back. If we can get Delvin, you know, available through NS, I think we're as good a chance this year as we were last year. And matchups are a big key, but I think we've shown we're the only team to beat Hong Kong twice, and we beat Alib twice. We beat Malaysia 4 times. So I think on our day, we can beat anyone. So our aspirations are still to win the championship. And obviously the semi-finals opponent may dictate how far we can go, but we're fairly confident we can make it to the final again this year and take that extra step.
Thanks a lot, Mike, and good luck for today. That was Michael Johnson, the general manager of the Seniors. And Michael Wong, just reflections now or predictions. Don't want to put you on the spot too much. Thoughts of the second half, the Seniors. Can they do it?
Yeah, definitely. They've been playing a very good game, very balanced game. You know, I think they're in a very good position to do well in this game as well.
20 seconds to go here, 20 seconds to go, 20 minutes to go in the game here, 10 minutes per quarter. The Slingers lead 38-34 of the Saigon Heat. Been playing well the first half, 20 minutes to go, and we will be back after this break for third quarter action from the OCBC Arena. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We got a good one here at the OCBC Arena, 38-34, Singapore Slingers over the Saigon Heat. Michael Wong and Chuck Schreiner with you. And one could have been forgiven to think, well, but, you know, without the X-Man, as much as he means to the Slingers, not much hope for Singapore, especially in light of the fact that they've already clinched, really not a whole lot to play for. They know they're going to have home court advantage throughout the playoffs, at least for the first round. Worked out that way, Michael.
Yeah, so Slingers have really been playing a little bit loose on the offensive end. They've been sharing the ball, they've been going through the opposite fence, through Howard at the low post, and getting a lot of open shots. So I think they're playing loosely, and there's no pressure on them at the moment. They secured a second seed position. They have nothing to lose, you know. All right now for them, the job is to go out there, have fun, you know, get a rhythm in, get a shot up, get some confidence back heading to the playoffs.
Singapore Slingers again have pushed the ball very effectively down the court behind the veteran presence of Josh Erzmann-Tondo and others. Leon Kwek with 10 points as well. Justin Howard with 10. And the Saigon that will control the ball. There is Arnold there coming at you from right to left in the red jerseys. Moses Morgan, Nguyen. Falling down is Volkoff. Enriquez, Morgan. There is Morgan. Check that, that's Daniels turning his defender inside out, but this is a shot. Great job on defense there by Delvin Goh. Nice recovery, it looked like he was beaten. Volkoff. Howard down low, the reverse is good. Losing Enrique, little drop step move by Justin Howard, slingers up by six. Arnold again, left hand dribble. Volkoff working against him. Morgan, top step, getting the ball over to Nguyen. Nguyen, Erzmann-Tondo fights around the screen. Inside, yes, and one. The foul will be on Howard. That will be two on him. So just like that, Justin Howard getting in with the hands. Watch this, rubbing off the screen is Erzmann-Tondo. Nice job to get the ball inside. Howard just a half step behind. Enrique not a great free throw shooter, but enough on that one to make it a three-point game. Back come Erzmann-Tondo and company. Volkoff, Erzmann-Tondo. Kwek on the right side, he will slash through. Howard, go. Around the screen, Erzmann-Tondo thought about it. Kwek with five on the shot clock. The little leaner is no good. Arnold picks up the loose ball, and back comes Saigon. Slants over to the right side. Morgan gets a step inside. He goes. Good defense. Go comes over to help out. Wide open look for Nguyen. Can't get it to fall. So Singapore dodged the bullet there. Erzmann-Tondo pushing it again. And a trademark of the slingers in this game. Without Alexander, Erzmann-Tondo getting the ball down the court in a hurry. Howard show and go there. Great job cradling the ball. Can't get the shot to fall. Enriquez down the court, kick back outside to Arnold, crossover, looking for the screen, wide open look on the three, stabs at it, can't get it to fall. Erzmann-Tondo again pushing the ball hard. That'll be a two, yes, Erzmann-Tondo. Great job by the veteran, getting down the court before anybody else, wide open look, why not? So Singapore up by five. Enriquez. Daniels on the flashing move from right to left. Oohs and ahs from the people there. And what is going on here? Daniels wants to know. Wanted a foul. Did not get it. Daniels going to get a technical foul, I believe. Look at him. Watch this. See if he has a case to make. So a technical foul, and Daniels, well, not a good move by him at all. Erzmann-Tondo will be at the line, Michael, and you know, you're not going to get every call. I don't care what league you're in, and maybe he had a case, maybe he didn't. I could not tell from that angle.
I think Daniels has been really frustrated by Delvin's defense. He was trying to take him off the block, but to no avail. So I think it's just a frustration call for right now.
Good point, Erzmann-Tondo. Off of the give by Volkoff. Howard gives it up, stays up on the high post, and then loses the ball. Moses getting around his man, easy two for him. So Singapore, their ninth turnover, and that's one thing we said that they needed to do in the second half, take care of the ball a little bit better. They lead by two at the 7-10 mark. Howard, little pass, lead, yeah! Great give and go there by Singapore, getting the ball into the hands of Kwek for 12 points now. Singapore back up by four. Great recognition there by Howard. Veteran move. Nguyen, Morgan, Daniel, still Daniel. Rolls it in, and Go having a hard time trying to match up with Lenny Daniel.
This is usually the X-Men's assignment. No? Right now he has four on Devin's goal shoulders. So it's a tall order, but I think he's done a fairly good job.
So the ball skidding off the hands of Justin Howard. There's that little give and go we were talking about before. Howard to Kwek. And after after that, a bucket by Saigon to get within two. Arnold looking inside. Daniel now being double-teamed. Somebody's got to be open as you win. They pass around the other side. Morgan way off the mark that time. Brisbentano again pushing the ball hard. Finds the lane, gets inside. Now he'll hold it up looking for Howard. Still, Brisbentano has the ball blocked away. Trying to do a little bit too much in the blocking foul there by Delvin Goh. Silly foul there by Delvin. So Goh now, I believe, with four fouls. Watch this. And tough going inside trying to go against a guy that's 7 feet tall. So Delvin Goh with four fouls. Arnold. Back outside to Daniel, swings it over to Moses Morgan. Moses Morgan, little stutter step move inside, clears out, got the roll and in. That ties it up at 45. So Singapore came out though with a full head of steam, but Saigon characteristically coming back and the game is tied again. Brisbentano in the lane, still Brisbentano. Howard, you can hit from there, not this time. Stepping in the lane, hitting the ball, let go back to Howard. Howard, yeah, no. See,
they caught a travel.
There's a traveling call on Justin Howard. So again, another turnover by Singapore. Let's watch it again. There's the shot. Rebound stepping in the lane is Delvin Goh. Pretty iffy call there, if you ask me, but you can see where. I think Justin, what we have here is that Mitchell Folkoff with the push off at the other end. You can see the mismatch there. Daniel's calling for the ball. Mitch seeing that he was in no man's land, so he grabs on. So two on Folkoff, and Singapore will call a timeout. When we come back, Saigon Heat will have the ball in a tie game, 45-45, and right now, Singapore coughing the ball up a couple times by my count anyway, Michael. That's 10 turnovers for the Slingers.
Yeah, they've got to take care of the basketball a little bit better. And on the defensive end, I think some of the Slingers are facing a little bit of an issue right now. With Delvin Goh and his four fouls, he's unable to stay on the court. And then there's no matchup right now for Daniels. So Daniels is bringing everything down to the low block and taking every one of these mismatches straight to the basket. So this is going to be something to look out for in the second half.
Another look at that little give and go play. Give and go, a synchronized play there between Justin Howard and Leon Quick. Well, Coach Yo's got to be talking right now. You know, yeah, we've got a guy with four fouls. We're not full strength, but come on, you've stayed with him this far. But you've got to take care of the ball. You cannot be turning the ball over. Let's watch it. Let's play tough defense. Let's push the ball whenever we can, but don't try and do too much with each possession. We'll be okay.
Yeah, they want to push the tempo, but they also want to make sure they slow it down appropriately. Like, if there's no chances on the transition, they're going to slow it down, you know, ride the big guy in the middle, try to drop the ball to the low block to the Howard, and then, you know, see what develops from there.
So Delvin Goh with four fouls, Leon Quick with three, Justin Howard with two. 5:20 to go here in the third quarter. Nguyen. Nguyen's on this Saigon team. The ball up in the air, saved by Daniel. Good heads up move by him. Moses, back up jumper. Got it. So breaking the tie then, Saigon with a little 7-0 run here against the Slingers. Tondo swings it over Quick, Quick. Wong who has checked into the game. So Folkoff also, the ball on the floor, picked up by Wong inside the lane. He goes. Folkoff forces it to back up jumper by him. Howard there to clean it up. Goes the other way. Got it. Justin Howard finds a way. Ties it up at 47. Nice move. Taking advantage of Enrique there. Arnold. Still Arnold. There's that matchup we were talking about. Daniels and Folkoff. Let's see if they take advantage. High up in the air. Knocked away by Howard. Good recognition by Justin there. Stutter step move, wide open look. Folkoff passing up the shot, gives it up to Bentondo. Back outside he goes, swings it to the right underneath to Howard. Howard! Thought there was a foul there. Back outside. Irvington will take the three. Can't get it to go. Wasted trip down the court there for Singapore. Enriquez. Off to Malone. So Morgan checked that. Mismatch is all over the place for Saigon. Daniel. Ooh, almost blocked that time. Wide open looking at that right-hand side. No good. Stepping in and pushing off. That will be against who? Leon Kwek. That will be four on Leon. With the push. And you can see these mismatches starting to cause some problems in the interior for Singapore. They don't really have the height to play the interior defense, so they're trying to do what they can physically, but that time, an obvious push there. So two Singapore singers before fouls.
No, I think they caught a foul on Howard. So okay. Howard has three fouls right now.
Howard with the foul. Morgan way off the mark there. Lead pass to Kwek. Kwek will take it all away. Can't get it to go. Nice defense there by Nguyen. Other end. Yes. Good job to get the ball to Daniels. Acrobatic move by him in the air. Saigon up again by two. Singapore slowing it down. Irvin Kondo. To Wong. Kicks it back outside to Howard. Now the other side, Irvin Kondo, who slanted through. Irvin Kondo, Howard will take that shot. Can't get it to fall that time. Rebound taken by Daniels. Back comes Arnold. Chance for Saigon now. Get a little breathing room in the lane. Little quick shot is good. So David Arnold. Slowly but surely, Saigon starting to establish a little bit of authority here in the third quarter at the 2:38 mark. Howard. Out of his comfort zone on that last shot, throws the screen, Irvin Kondo in the lane. Again, off the glass, Leon Kwek. Nice move there by Leon, playing way beyond his 20 years, so 2-point lead now by Saigon. Enriquez, still Enriquez with the left hand, looking for Daniels, and again, being covered by two players, Arnold on the left side. Inside the lane he goes, can't get it to fall. Daniels cleans it up again. So more and more without going there. And you can see what the difference is. Only one big man, the matchup cost is causing Singapore. Again, go on the bench with four fouls. Volkov, he steps out. He's got Wong to his right. Bounce pass inside for Irvin Kondo. He's covered. Howard! Foul. Good job by Howard. You can see how Saigon's packing it in on the defensive end. Watch it again. Bounce pass. Good job. Irvin Kondo finding Howard, who trails, and then hack across the chest by Enriquez. That'll be three on him, I believe. So Howard for two. Hits the first one. Chance for Singapore to get back within two. Again, trying to get it done without their star, Xavier Alexander, who in the last four games, all he's done is score three triple-doubles. Enriquez has to chase that ball down. Seven-footer. Doesn't handle the ball too bad for a big man. Arnold. Screened by Enriquez. Stepping around is Irvin Kondo. Kick back outside. Moses Morgan for three. No. Howard tips it back out into the lane as Irvin Kondo, and he's fouled. Good foul there by Saigon. Looked like Singapore had a three-on-one going. But you got to like Michael Wong, what Singapore is doing on the offensive end, pushing the ball whenever they get a chance. Look at that lead pass, and he had Howard ahead of him. So good job by Saigon. Howard again, off the glass, up and in. Howard now with 18. He averages 22. And Singapore is tied it at 53. 105 to go here in the third. Nguyen working against Wong. Circling over is Arnold. Arnold will stop. Back up. Jumper is going to be short. In the lane it goes. Corralled by Moses Morgan. A foul at the other side. Looked like Volkov getting mixed up with Daniels. Daniels can't believe it. He's got to watch it. He's already been called for one technical. Two and you're out. So Daniels and Volkov getting into it. I think Mitch Volkov, you know, he's not nearly as tall as Daniels, but he hustles a lot, and he's got very good instincts, does Volkov. I think he's causing some problems, so they will go and sit down and cool off a little bit. They will need him. and what promises to be a heck of a fourth quarter. Singapore trailed by two at the half. Irvin Tondo, his running buddy, will be Quek, who will jog over to the left-hand side. Now Folkoff, Wong. Wong with the left hand in the lane. The little runner is good. He will go to the line. Wong Wei Long. Well, they're starting to find some space in the creases now, Michael. Check it out again. Nguyen fouls, getting around the other Nguyen, Von Hung Nguyen, so Stefan Nguyen with the foul. So Wong, the MVP the last 2 years for local players. Streakiest shooter as you will find in the ABL. So completing the three-point play, and Singapore with the three-point lead. And just like that, the momentum is gone, Michael. Singapore will get the ball back. Saigon, Enriquez gets the ball to Nguyen. Out pops Arnold again. Desmond Oh checking into the game. Enriquez working against Howard. Turn, fire, foul, got it, and one. Howard will have four fouls now. So not good news for Singapore. That stays the way it is. Yes, Justin Howard now with four fouls. So Enrique going straight to work on Justin Howard. And now Singapore with both their big men in big, big trouble with a whole quarter to go.
Well, this is a move you have not seen for Hurricanes for a long time. Like, he hasn't gone to the basket like this strong. So I think he knows that Howard is on his third foul, and he's hoping to buy one from the referees, and he got one.
So that will tie it up, and you can bet every trip down they're going to try and get the ball to Enrique and go straight at Howard. Howard will be pretty much defenseless. So Singapore in foul trouble. They will, however, play for the last shot here in the fourth quarter, try and take a slim lead going into that final 10 minutes. Irvin Tondo gets the ball inside. Howard will fight for it. The ball knocked away. Last touch by Saigon. Singapore will have the ball, I believe, with 2.2. on the clock. Now, is that foul going to go on Enrique? If it is, that will be three on him. Let's watch it again. Oh boy, tough to see there. No foul called. Get another look at it from a different angle. Singapore, yes, they will tie it up with 1 second to go, and Singapore will take the 2-point lead going into the fourth quarter, 58-56. Coach Michael Johnson coming out on the floor to talk to Justin Howard and say, don't worry about it. We got the bucket we needed. There's the inbound pass. There's been Tano with the fadeaway jumper at the buzzer. Singapore will have the 2-point lead with 10 minutes to go here at the OCBC Arena. Don't go away. We've got a great one. We'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a barn burner here, 58-56 in the OCBC Arena. Let's check out the three-quarter stats. 26 of 55, Singapore 47%, 24 of 54, not much in that. Look at the rebounds, though. 36-22 in favor of the Slingers. Turnovers, Slingers, 11 turnovers compared to four. So you look at the rebounds, you look at the turnovers, pretty much the story of the game so far, Michael. Singapore has to do a much better job in the fourth quarter of taking care of the ball.
Yeah, they definitely have to take care of the ball better, because that will lead to transition baskets for the Saigon Heat, and that's easy baskets for them. You want to make them work for every single point that they make on you, because they don't have a bench right now. They don't have a deep bench. They want to really ride them out on every single possession.
So Go with four fouls. Howard with four fouls for Singapore. So they're two bigs in deep trouble. Urban Tondo has been the man, hitting that bucket at the end of the dying embers of the third quarter. Oh, beautiful move. Blocked away, though. Desmond O with a nice move, getting the ball to Folcott, who gets the shot blocked. Back comes Saigon. Nguyen up over the top. Gets the ball over to Morgan for the easy two and finding that mismatch. And that's what Coach Garbelaar, no doubt, is going to be talking with the Saigon Heat. We've got mismatches in the interior. Let's take advantage of them. Try and get Howard out of the game as quickly as possible. Wong around one screen. Hesitation. Back inside. Volkoff again putting the ball on the floor. For some reason, the tip pass almost out of bounds. Yes! Great job by Volkoff. Underneath the basket, somehow extending with the left arm and getting it to fall. Pardon me, that was Wong. So 60-58. Bounce pass Enrique. Now let's see if he works on Howard. He does. Howard. Shot is off the mark. What do we have here? A foul, and that's going to go off on Volkoff. Wow. So Mitchell Volkoff now, he has two. First team foul for the Slingers. Let's see if that puts a shooter at the line. No, I think they will take the ball out of bounds. Singapore trying so hard not to foul. It just seems like they're attracting fouls like magnets.
It's definitely very tough for them to match up with Lenny Davis and Moses right now, because they're obviously outsized right now.
Well, you know, you want to save a go on the bench just in case Howard does foul out. Again, going downstairs to Enrique. Enriquez posts up around Howard, up and in off the glass, and you can see Howard pretty much defenseless. He can't, all he can do is try and keep Enriquez away from the glass, but can't really do an adequate job defensively. So that is a play that no doubt Saigon will go to again and again here in the fourth quarter. Let's see if Singapore can make up for it. Inside the lane, off to Howard. Howard thought about it, now takes the shot, no good. Enriquez gets the rebound, loses the ball out of bounds, but last touch by Folkoff trying to steal the ball from behind. So 60-60, 8:05 mark here at the OCBC Arena. Chuck Schreiner, Michael Wong with you. Regular season game, dying embers of this 2016-2017 season before we start a new season, the playoffs. That will be covered here. Inside, Arnold, easy two for him. You can see the mix-up on defensive assignments there. Urban Tondo sort of saying, I thought you had him. No, I'm supposed to have him. Okay, so a lead now for Saigon. They lead by two. They've led by as many as four. Desmond O, Volkoff, Wong. Wong in the lane. Still Wong. Backs it up a little bit. He'll take the long three and be off the mark on that. Singapore does not want to become a jump-shooting team here in the fourth quarter. They need to do the thing that has worked well for them. Inside it goes, easy two, and you can see with Howard defenseless on the interior, Daniels just knifing through, easy layup for him. Defense on the outside has got to do a better job of stepping in the way of the penetrator. So 4-point lead now, matching the biggest lead of the game for Saigon. Howard trying to mix it up downstairs. Enriquez on him. Tondo, still Urban Tondo, trying to get some separation. This dives up at two, no good. Stepping in to get the rebound is Daniels. Back come Saigon, 6:50 to go. Dumps the ball inside, knocked away. Last touch by Folkoff. Saigon will have the ball. Checking into the game will be Leon Quick. Quick with three fouls.
Delvin's back into the game.
Delvin go. So all or nothing for the Slingers right now. They can't wait until Saigon stretches the lead any further. Enriquez around the screen. Arnold thought about it. Now he goes around. Goes through. It's the tip back in by Enriquez. Biggest lead of the game now by Saigon as they are on a little 6-0 run. So Singapore desperately needing something on offense. Erzman Tano, little skip pass over to the left-hand side now. Quick, baseline movement, loses it out of bounds. Another turnover for Singapore. Nothing going right here. So a disaster of a fourth quarter so far for the Slingers.
This is a very dangerous situation for the Slingers right now. Foul situation has been really bad for them. Offensively, they're not getting any rhythm.
Arnold, and again, going attacking the interior, attacking Howard, who really all he can do is stand there. And really, it's incumbent on the players on the backcourt, on defense, or on the outside of the defense, to at least try and stop this dribble penetration. They've really done nothing, and you can't really blame Justin Howard. Look at this. Nobody even around, and what's he supposed to do?
This is a lack of communication. They should have shouted out, you know, assigned their defensive duties earlier than that. And they cannot, like you said, you cannot allow them to drive straight to the basket, because you know Howard is on his fourth foul. He would not challenge any single shot right now, unless he's in position to do so.
So Singapore doing the right thing, and then, you know, the glaring absence of Xavier Alexander showing its head right now, because with Alexander in the game, I mean, he not only helps on the offensive end, but he's a very good defender as well. So lack of communication, as Michael said, and again, the inability of the bigs, either Delvin Gold or Justin Howard, to stop it once the ball gets inside. Unless they want to foul out, they basically all they can do is just throw up their arms and let it go. So 8-point lead. Singers will have the ball. Let's see what they can do on offense. They really don't want to get in the position where they're just having to hoist up threes, because we know how that has gone for the Slingers as of late. What has worked for them is in the open court, with Erzman Tano trying to push the ball, getting the open looks, and getting the ball downstairs to Howard. He can either take the ball to the basket himself or kick it back outside. So let's see what happens. Erzman Tano on to the right is Quek. Quek is having a good game, 14 points for him. Howard downstairs. Larry Liu takes the shot, and he's off the mark. So one and out again for the Slingers. Arnold switches over to the left hand. He'll wait. Again, the other side, Daniels takes it to the basket. Really nobody inside that's gonna stop him. So a 10-point lead, a 10-0 run for the Saigon Heat. Looking downstairs, Howard, he will draw a double team, bumping and grinding with Enriquez, and there's your foul. That'll be three on Jordan. That'll send Howard to the line for two.
It seems like the only thing going right now for the Singapore Slingers is to drop the ball down low to Howard. As you can see here, Enriquez cannot really match up with him down at the low block.
Enriquez doesn't really have the cleanest of footwork, as we have seen. Howard's been able to victimize him time and time again. So Justin with 18 at the line, a chance to add to that. As we said, couple of Slingers in foul trouble, actually three if you count Leon Quek as well, and Justin having some problems adjusting his uniform. Off the first shot. Justin Howard's family here from the States, his mother and cousin, girlfriend also courtside. This is Xavier Alexander's better half. Welcome to Singapore. Ball to Morgan. Morgan, wide open look from Freesville, and just keeps getting worse and worse for the Slingers. So he now scored 13-1. They trail by 12 with 5:14 to go. Go. Quek around the screen. Pass down low, and a foul. That'll be on Arnold. So they spot the mismatch. Justin Howard is fouled. Singapore will have the ball out the baseline. So next week, these two teams will do battle again in Saigon. And what a loud gym that is, if you've ever been there. Inside, saved by Erzman Tano off the foot from the elbow, off the mark. Quek gets his own rebound. They'll crank it up again. Larry Liu to Erzman Tano. Erzman Tano, Nguyen working on him. Here comes the screener as Matano slips one defender. Hesitation move inside. Go around one defender. He is fouled. Foul there will go on Moses Morgan, I believe, and that will stop the clock at the 4:41. Better stuff by Singapore on this trip down the court. You see Delvin go, and there is your foul. And I believe That is going to be on Lenny Daniel, who, check that, Jordan Henriquez are going to say. So for Henriquez, that's four on him. So Singapore with 441, a glimmer of hope here. Delvin gets the first of two. That will get the lead down to 11. You can see a very pensive coach, Anthony Garbaletto. He realizes as a coach, it's not over till it's over. And he sees his big man now with four fouls. Delvin, one of two. Henriquez cleans up the rebound. So Singapore needing some stops here, and Arnold off balance shot, no good. Rebound by Howard to go off to Josh. Josh switches over to the right hand, stops. Back outside it goes, and Arnold will pick it up, and he will go coast to coast. Easy two. Big mistake there by Singapore. Just when they needed to stop, they don't get it. In fact, they give up the easy two on the turnover. That's 13 turnovers for the Slingers. Watch it again. Pass to nobody. Arnold alertly right there to pick it up and off the glass and in. So 75-62, Singapore down by 13. Wow. Well, a couple of things have hurt Singapore. You know, we can talk about the absence of Xavier Alexander, but you know, yet on the other side of the ball, Singapore, it just seemed like when Howard picked up that fourth foul, it just became very, very desperate for Singapore. And you know, Saigon did the right thing. You've got to hand it to him. Tactically, they went straight at Howard. Howard really couldn't do much about it. And then they started switching it up where Howard, they kept his defensive opponent on the outside, and that created more mismatches on the inside for people like Howard and Moses Morgan to attack the basket. And Saigon's been pretty relentless ever since then. They have owned the fourth quarter.
Yeah, I think it started with Devin Go getting his fourth foul, because there was actually a mismatch on Danny Daniels. So that came on the first bout, and then the second one will be Howard getting his fourth foul, and then that puts Singapore Slingers in situation where they have not countered before with their two bigs in foul trouble, and they don't have the X-Men right now. So it creates a situation where right now they're very passive, and the whole team seems to crumple after that instant.
So Erzman Tondo, Singers need a score here and some stops. Here at the OCBC Arena, Wong, gets around one man and a foul from behind by Nguyen Van Hung. Two on him with the push. Again, that stops the clock. Watch it again from a different angle. Weak side help coming over. Really no need for the foul. You can see Daniel providing the weak side help there. So Wong, as we said, probably Singapore's best free throw shooter at the line to try and cut the deficit to 11 to give Singapore a fighting chance. If they can get it done on the offensive end, and if they can take care of the ball. So that's what it's going to get down to. Two of two. Full court pressure. Daniel pushing off against Go. Here comes Arnold. Saigon lining up deep. Arnold trips for a moment. Ball up, falls away. Howard gets the rebound. Lead pass. There is Bentondo. He's got Quek on the right hand side. Back to Howard. Howard! See if he gets the continuation. No. Were they going to say a traveling call? No.
Count it.
Yeah, he will get it. He will get the continuation. So, and one situation. So, 9-point lead now. Howard at the line to try and make it 8. Arnold missing an easy shot at the opposite end. So, 9-point game. Singapore with a little, or 8-point game. Singapore with a little bit of hope. And Xavier Alexander trying to fire it up for Singapore on the bench. Arnold. Wong working against him. Out pops Morgan. Opposite side, Morgan. Morgan slicing through the lane, off balance. Shot is up and in. Wow. Moses Morgan leaning to his right. Nothing but net. Back up to 10. Wong. Back outside. Go. Quet. Looking for Howard. Howard with it now. Howard. A little bit too shallow for him. Go will take that shot from the elbow. No good. One and out. Daniel cleans it up. Back comes Saigon in no hurry at the three-minute mark. Accelerates. Getting right around Delvin Goh, and Howard defenseless there at the other end. So before you know it, back up to 12 points. Matongo, Goh, Wong, Howard now. Enrique, remember, working with four fouls. Kick back outside, Wong. Blocking foul. Let's see who they give that to. Whoa. Is that Enriquez? If it is, that will be five on him. Let's watch it again. Enriquez. That will put the Heat in the penalty situation. Was not on Enriquez.
I think it was on Arnold.
So Arnold with three now. That does stop the clock. So Wong at the line for the second successive time that he has been down the court. Singapore trying to hold on here. Back rims that. Well, it was going to always be a tough ask for the Slingers without the X-Men, as hot as Saigon has been. Nevertheless, you don't want to lose on your own home court. Singapore doing a great job the first three quarters. Now 2.5 to go. They're going to have to find a different formula if they're going to win this game. They will fall to 12-7. Saigon would clinch the fourth playoff spot, and up and in, and that just might be the dagger right there. 81-67, 14-point lead now for the Saigon Heat, and they can smell it, Michael Wong. This would make them 8-10, and they would nail down that fourth and final playoff spot. There's the give to Enrique. On the mismatch, there's Howard and Cueca. He's 6'3", Enrique is 7 feet tall, so do the math on that one. There was no way that was going to be any other way. We look at the standings right now. So Saigon would be 8-10 with two games to go. You look at both the Dragons have 13 losses, as do the Truth. So the worst Saigon could be if they lost both of their remaining games would be 8-12. And the best Westport could be would be 7-13. Kaohsiung also with 13 losses. They could be 7-13. So right there. In fact, Saigon Heat have an outside chance. Should a lot of Pilipinas lose their final two games, they would be 9-11. And should Saigon Heat go from 8-10 to 10-10, they would climb over the top of the lob, and all of a sudden, they are in third place. Now, however, they do have to overcome a formidable schedule the last two games, Michael. They would have to beat Singapore again, Singapore with a healthy Xavier Alexander, and then, of course, they would have to beat Hong Kong on the road. So, but there is a path. That's the point. Howard is going to be off with that. Off the hand of Enrique. So it looked like he wanted to get a fast break going there before he had control of the ball. So Singapore will inbound it with 2:08 to go. Howard back outside to Irvin Tondo. There's the screen. Volkov. Howard can't get it to fall. Had to rush his shot just a little bit and losing it. Picking it up is Morgan. Both these teams look a little bit disjointed, but it looks like the Saigon Heat is going to be mission accomplished for them. They come into the OCBC Arena unless something spectacular happens in the last minute 40. They will beat Singapore two consecutive times on their own home court, and that should nail it down right there, 83-67. Valiant try by the Slingers for three quarters anyway, but they just ran out of gas in the last quarter, Michael. Wong working against Arnold. Head down, slivers through the lane, and gets the shooter's roll. So 83-69. Wong way long here with 12 points. Actually 14. Nothing wrong with the effort on the floor by the Slingers. And all credit to the Saigon Heat, Michael Wong. They took care of the ball. By my count, they've only got 5 or 6 turnovers. Singapore, 13 or 14 turnovers. Just not the same team without the X-Man in the game. He is such a consistent force and a calming force. almost like a big brother, even though he's only 28. I mean, I know Wong is older than him even, but and we know Howard at 35 years old, I guess he could be sort of the father of the group, whereas the X-Man is sort of like the big brother of the group. So when you lose your big brother, so to speak, you know, it's really tough. And Xavier with the triple-double in three of the last four games, he's just such a calming influence for the Slingers, and they miss his leadership a lot.
Yeah, besides the triple-double, one thing that is sorely missing right now is the matchup with Lenny Daniels. Right now, there's no one who can actually defend him at the low block. I remember the last time when they matched up, I think Lenny Daniels couldn't have such an easy time going to the basket. Today, he had probably like three dunks on his own or five layups. So with the X-Men around, I don't think it would be so easy for him to score this 26 points of his.
Daniels averages 22 points a game. So they could play each other one more time. Now we know that they play each other one more time in Saigon, but it could end up the way the Saigon team is playing. If they win their next two, and I know it's a tall order, they're going to have to beat Singapore, but at least that game is on the road. It is at their house. And if they can beat Hong Kong on the road, and a lot of Filipinas keeps a nosedive, and like they're doing, they've got to play Hong Kong today. Another basket there by Arnold. Then it could end up where Singapore does indeed play Saigon again, and that's a matchup that I don't think Singapore really wants at this moment. There's Volkov with the jumper, which is good. So Singapore, without the presence of Alexander, giving up 85 points, and you don't see Singapore giving up that many points. For instance, last week against Kaohsiung, they gave up only 52. Ball on the floor now, and Enriquez picks it up. So under a minute to play. Daniels working against Volkov. That's a mismatch. He's had all the third and fourth quarter, easily getting past Volkov, who fouls. That'll stop the clock, and Daniels will go to the line to try and earn it. He's got 23 at the moment. So, you know, you can play the what-if game all day long, but you just get the feeling Singapore, the way they were wound up to play this game, they wanted to prove something today, but and they were able to do it for the first 30 minutes, but it's just a bridge too far without your one of your two best players. I think Usman Tano played his heart out, especially the first two quarters today. He is in double figures. Leon Kwek has had a good game. Wong has had a good game. So offensively, really not a whole lot that you can say bad about Singapore, except for their turnovers and the fact that they got in foul trouble. And you can just say, as you said, Michael, sort of the air went out of the balloon when Howard picked up that fourth foul.
Yeah, I think they did a very, very good job competing the whole entire game, you know, dealing with whatever adversity they had. So it's a good showing for the boys as well.
Off the mark, cleaned up by Enriquez, and Howard. Ball controlled. Back downstairs, on the floor again, and Moses Morgan will pick up the foul with 3.7 seconds to go here in the ball game from the OCBC Arena. And indeed, the Saigon Heat think about what they've been able to do the last 3 weeks. They've been coming here in enemy territory and taking the game to the Singapore Slingers twice, beating Singapore on their own home court, and not only that, beating Hong Kong. Now, if you were a cynic, you could say, yeah, but, you know, they beat Singapore without Alexander. You know, they beat Hong Kong without Josh Boone, who was suffering from back spasms. But, you know, you only have control of the players that are on the floor. So a win is a win is a win. And the Singapore Slingers, although they're going to finish second, they're a little bit of doubt's going to have to be creeping in their game, Michael. The last eight games, they are 3-5. So they can't wait to get their team together, get healthy, and maybe try and make a statement down in Saigon next week. Maybe they can escape there with a win. Both those teams will have already, you know, clinched their playoff places. So at the buzzer, Usman Tano with a miss, and Singapore will lose this game 88-71. And the Saigon Heat will make the playoffs. So Singapore just running out of gas in the fourth quarter. They kept it close. In fact, they led by as many as 4 points most of the way through that fourth quarter, but really were outclassed in that fourth quarter. And as we said before, when the fouls started to mount up and the turnovers started to mount up, Saigon was just much the better team the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, Saigon definitely did a very good job on identifying where the mismatches are. They played a very efficient game, looking at where the mismatches are, and then they just attack at it.
So Saigon, who at one point in the season were in last place, Michael, I think there was something like 2-7, or 1-6, something like that. They have come back all the way. It was a revolving door for their players. They switched their expats again and again and again. They finally found the combination that worked with them. You know, Lenny Daniels able to work real well with Moses Morgan and Jordan Enriquez. And, of course, don't underestimate David Arnold, the heritage player that brings so much to this team. And they're a happy bunch right now. They know that there is a tomorrow for them. And for any basketball team in any league, I don't care what it is, you want to make the playoffs. And the Saigon Heat has just done that. And full marks to them and their coach, Anthony Garbelletto. As we look at the play of the day, and there it is right there. Good control in the air by Lenny Daniels for two of his 25, at the other end, Leon Kwek. And here it is again, Enrique starting the fast break in transition. Over the top, the pass from Arnold to Daniel. One more look at it from the other side. And there you go, your play of the day here at the OCBC Arena, 88-71. A comprehensive victory in that fourth quarter for the Saigon Heat as they overcome the Singapore Slingers and walk out here as we look at the statistics. 43%, Singapore was shooting up to nearly 50% at the end of the first half. They finished with 43%. Look at Saigon, they rise to 51. Rebounds, even they, when Howard got the fourth foul, that even starts to even up 41-35. Look at the turnovers, 14-5 in favor of the Saigon Heat. They do a great job of taking care of the ball, Michael, and the fourth quarter belonged to Saigon, and that was the difference in the game.
Yeah, looking at how they fair, right? I think the Saigon Heat really played a very, very strategized game.
So look at the standards, the standings with one game to go. Hong Kong Eastern rises to 15-3 after they fall to 15-3 because of the team that came in here and beat Singapore, who are now at 8-10. Singapore clinching second place, 12-7. We'll have to see that a lot. Filipinas game today. We will see if Saigon can climb even closer. Later tonight, as we just said, the Alab Pilipinas going against Hong Kong Eastern Long Lines. That is it, Alab. So for Michael Wong, this is Chuck Schreiner. For all the people, production here at Arena, we'll invite you back next week. Same time, same place. Well, not same time, same place. We will be featuring a game not in Singapore. Singapore's last home game of the season. And they go down to a loss, 88-71, against this team from Saigon. Full marks to them as they make the playoffs. So OCBC Arena, final score again, Heat 88, Slingers 71. So long for now.